Hey guys, Cool Blind Away back. I'm Rick.
Shane.
Eric.
I'm Aaron.
I'm Calvin.
We're back with Hunter.
Hunter.
I think the end of an era.
Could be.
Of an arc. Last time was Victor and Loser, and definitely that's what happened.
But okay. Neither of them.
Genthru lost
Victor.
Real hard.
I felt like Genthru won because he's still alive. And his friends are alive and healed.
Yeah, but Gon and them, I don't know if they. Do they kill too often?
And Killua
definitely does
more.
Yeah,
as an assassin.
And I would say that in her time, Biski has killed many people.
We don't know that.
Gon is slow to forgive often.
But yeah, I guess.
Remember, he spent a year trained just so he could punch Ahsoka back. Or however long it was they were at the Evans Arena.
So they have to take a quiz now. We just saw a test in Naruto.
We did.
We also saw an ambush or something. My view is just...
Yeah, it could be people trying to help him, could be people trying to fight him.
Well, they're all healed.
Or people to cheat off of him.
I don't think
there's
damage of chance.
I feel like Killua should be the one answering questions.
Do you think you can cheat in this quiz?
And get away with it?
Is that part of the quiz?
They didn't say he couldn't.
Does Gene look like a cheater?
See, in any other show, or I should say any other genre, I'd be like, oh, all of this is going to end with the quiz? That seems anticlimactic, but I'm super excited for this quiz.
I'm ready.
Let's do it.
All right.
Great place to end.
You know, it
really
a little bit with that fishing pole out and stuff.
If it's him, if it's not him,
it's gonna be some like mannequin or something that he's set up.
He's doing it on the assumption that his father brought him here, and that's why his name is that. But it also could not be. It could be just someone else.
He's just assuming those things. But
yeah, didn't he say he didn't want found by his son? Did he tell him that
in the message?
Yeah,
but
he said, "I'm not doing this so that you can find me," right?
Something like that.
So that you can get answers if you want them.
But then the tape was going to continue more, and it didn't tell him.
It's so goddamn sweet that he's like, what are you going to do with your phone? I'm going to say that Killua's my best friend. It's so great. I love
him.
Yeah. I guess that's it for Biski for now.
Yeah, I love Biski. You know, when they first introduced Biski, and she was like, I'm going to, like... do something to those boys. I'm like, oh, who the hell is this? I hate her.
Yeah.
I really like her now.
Yeah.
I just wish that we could have gotten one more shot of giant Biski like crying. His voice.
Like you. You're biased. That's why.
I'm very biased.
Why did she want a marble?
Blue Planet.
I want to look up what that does.
What does Blue Planet do? Is there like, is she like a god now? Is there like a real planet in there?
No, I don't think it's
like.
It's like
a men planet?
I think it's like Men in Black.
The only thing I know.
Galaxy?
Is that, yeah.
Blue Planet, well, I don't know, I had 81 twice. Blue Planet, I think, might have been number card 81.
Okay. What did Blue Planet do? And why did she want it? She's like, oh, it's so cute, I love it, you know? Did she just collect marbles and it's a very specific type of blue?
It's very rare.
It is a rare blue gemstone that can only be found in Greed Island. It's a completely spherical gem which holds a brilliant blue color. It reflects light in a way that resembles the moving atmosphere of a planet, hence where the gem derives its name.
Okay.
So it likes it for its beauty.
And its rarity. It's the only way you can get it out in the real world.
Yeah, right. I mean, yeah. It's the only one. But
is it worth anything in the real world? So at least she wants to keep it.
And she
just
wants it.
And pet it. And stroke its pretty beak and pet its pretty feathers.
Call it Bluey, Planety, and Bluette.
No, Planet.
Yeah.
Smurfette.
I love that Gene changed his friend's name.
Legally.
To match his skin.
He legally changed his name an hour later.
No, a minute.
A minute.
A minute later.
It was a minute.
Yeah. He just sent a phone call and he changed his man's name to get his foil. He's a hunter. Oh, he can do it.
I wonder what the other names are. We have I-S-A-N and D that they didn't mention.
We only got Greed, right?
Yeah. Greed and List, which was from the island.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I wrote island. I was trying to write him down. I wrote island, and I wrote island the other way too.
Yeah.
So I wrote island this way.
It does feel like, you know, we're done with Green Island. Maybe it won't come back, but will we ever meet the other?
Well, I wonder,
letters?
Like, why are they there working on the island? Like Razor, I get because it's almost like another prison for him, kind of in a way. But he's just doing it as a favor to Gene. Are they all just doing it as a favor to him, or are they getting paid?
I mean, they make money selling copies of the game. You know, it's like any kind of theme park.
But they don't sell them anymore.
Well,
like right now, it's like a retro game.
Yeah.
Where like, you know, if I want Nintendo 64 games, I'm not gonna go to Walmart and buy a brand new copy. Sure. I have to find people that
like, why are the servers still being maintained? And
yeah, I just wonder what their process is.
Do they spend real money on the spells in, like, Masadora?
Maybe. There might be, like, it's like that. Some kind of currency thing. I forget what they spent on it. I think they said Jenny or something, didn't they?
I thought
when they were
so.
Doing it.
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah, man, it's like a it's like getting like the first. It's like getting the year pass at like Disney World, and only those people with this pass can go to Disney World, and they just go every day.
So this game
they live there in Disney World.
It's like Westworld.
Yeah.
How old is Gun?
It's like 12 or 13.
So it's been at least running that many years.
Yeah.
If he came there as a baby.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So they've just been there on that island for that many years.
They have a whole economy, a whole horror city. They have what they need.
Damn, in episode 6, 60, 1 minute or car turns into item.
Yeah. Really? Gotcha.
I guess they're just kind of living in the Matrix, right? Like,
except it's real.
Yeah, but, well, I mean, they're living on a private island, pretty much, with its own, like, system. And they can do magic, which is cool.
Just seems like the twins got the real short end of the stick. They
yeah.
have to be in that little room all day.
Yeah.
Maybe that's what they enjoy.
That's why I said, man, they're cast members, but they're not. They're actually one of the creators. But, yeah, they're not Nen creation people. So that question was answered, at least.
Yeah.
Very quickly.
Yeah.
Alina? Normally we just don't get answers. Yeah.
I wonder how long it's going to be before we see Krapika and Leorio again.
We had this whole arc without them. Yeah, I don't know. When's the next time we'll see Hisoka? When's the next time we'll see the Krollo thing? I mean, we had that, like, they got the Exorcist out, right?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So.
He's going to go make a lot of money on this exorcism job.
Dude, this has only really been since, like, episode 60 or so.
Mm-hmm.
Like, it's only been, like, 15 episodes.
Yeah, it feels like so much longer than that, but.
So.
It's just a good time.
What happened, like, how does the Paladin's Necklace, that switcheroo work?
So, the Paladin's Necklace, one of the things that it does is it protects you from...
Yeah. Spells, right?
Well, from someone giving you a false card.
Okay.
So you can hide what a card looks like and try to, like, trade it to someone.
Yeah.
It reverts cards to their true form.
Okay.
So but they snuck past a company, which is not a slot card.
Which isn't a card, card that, yeah...
So you normally couldn't get that out of the game, but when she saw it, it looked like a strip of beach card, which is a slot card.
Yeah.
But then they used the necklace to change it back to its original form.
Gotcha.
And because they didn't use programming and they used a human to do it, user error allowed it through.
Okay. I was going to say, that was kind of a risk to do that. What if Flavor's like, you can't do that? But no one's ever done it before, so they weren't looking out for it.
And now, like, the necklace is just worthless. It doesn't do anything in the real world, I don't think.
Not that we know of, but you can still wear it because.
Yeah.
Of all the cards that we've seen, what would you guys have taken?
I mean, Angel's Breath.
Angel's Breath seems pretty
because,
good.
Yeah. Like, it's one of the few that we know the name of and what it does.
I can't even remember what Strip of Beach does.
Yeah, what does Strip of Beach do?
I'll look.
Maybe Sword of Truth.
Sword of Truth, yeah.
What did that do?
I don't know, but it's a sword of truth. Sounds cool.
I think that one, like...
Why not?
If you use it on someone, they have to answer you and they can't lie or something.
It's like Wonder Woman's name.
The entrance to a cave called Poseidon's Cavern. The cave changes its path at each visit, confusing intruders? What is it the effect is?
There was something about trying to find a...
like the pirate's treasure,
a hidden
right?
treasure trove thing. And, like, Ship of Beach might have been the only way that you could actually find it, maybe. So, honestly, it's not that useful in the real world.
But also, it wasn't, like... The treasure trove just bullshit because they made it up anyway. Like a whole bunch of pirates came here and enslaved them and shit. And they're like, no, it's there's nothing going on here. We're just prosperous.
It was rumors.
Yeah. Isn't that what that woman was saying?
She says something like that, and then it was all about the view.
Yeah.
Something like that, yeah.
Oh, okay. So, do you guys want to know what Ruler's Blessing does?
Yes.
A castle given as a prize for winning the contest town with 10,000 people. Included. Its residents will live according to whatever laws and commands you issue.
Holy shit!
Holy
You just
shit.
Get a town with 10,000 people that you can rule? That's fucking amazing.
That's what that guy's been doing for like 12 years.
Maybe.
A pitcher of eternal water seems useful. A jar from which pure clean water continuously flows.
Huh.
up to 1,440 liters per day.
Put one of those in half.
Skin care hot springs, a hot spring that cures you of any skin condition. Bathing in it for half an hour a day gives you skin as soft and smooth as a baby's.
That would be too bad. Save that for my older age. If I really get there.
Get rid of your sunburn.
Mm. Yeah.
Liquor spring. What? Draw some of this spring water, and an hour later it becomes a random alcoholic drink. Of exquisite taste and extraordinary quality.
Exquisite. Random.
I like that one. Dude, mix that one with the last one you just mentioned, Rick. Because that's water turns into alcohol?
Pregnancy stones.
No.
Carry a stone for 1 month, you will get pregnant. Even if you're male, you may choose the sex of the baby.
Huh? Holy shit, that would have been crazy to take.
I don't need that. I know.
Mystery pond, release one fish into this pond, and there will be one more fish of that type the next day. You can keep any combination of fish in this pond, even saltwater and freshwater fish together.
That's kind of cool. That's
Golden
cool.
Guide.
Some rich guy would pay a lot for that.
A travel guide that lists where you can meet people of the opposite sex who are your type.
Definitely get that at Warzone.
Who are
your type.
Huh.
Yeah. Golden Scales. I might take this one. When faced with a two-option choice, the scales will tell you which is better for your future.
That's pretty good.
That's a slot cool. card?
B30. I don't know.
Yeah.
Number 11. Yes. That's pretty cool.
Yeah, that's pretty good. But the problem is trying to condense your life down into two-option decisions.
Yeah, true. Golden Dictionary, each day you will find a word glowing gold. You should learn those words because they will come in handy the next day.
Yes.
These are really cool ideas.
Yeah, that's like a much, much better version of Word of the Day.
Yeah.
It's Word of Tomorrow.
Eric would have to watch what he does. Like, would it be...
Yeah.
Am I going to go to Empire Buffet or the other Chinese restaurant? I'd be like, well, no, go to the other Chinese restaurant. It's better. He's like, well, am I going to go to Empire Buffet or nothing? He's like, well, you better eat.
Obviously, you have to eat.
Empire Buffet. Yeah.
So you get what you want.
So he's got to put it down to what you want. That way it's like, I'm doing what it tells me. This is better for me.
Well, I could just be like, all right, I'm filling out my lottery card. What numbers do I want? Do I want one or two? And I just spend like a thousand
years.
Oh, my
gosh. Oh, my gosh.
Imp's wink. You will experience the most amazing ecstasy when she winks at you. She can appear multiple times. Be warned, it can get addictive.
Oh, okay. Ooh.
Eric, actually, what you do with the lottery is, like, pick your six numbers, whatever it is, and then it's like, should I enter this lottery ticket today? Yes or no? Like, okay. And wait for it to say yes.
Yeah.
Like, I got it finally.
That's funny.
It might be more likely to find it.
There's a bunch of cool ones.
I wonder if these are, like, in the manga. Because I don't feel like we saw all these throughout this, you know?
Connection-severing scissors. Cut a picture of someone you don't want to see with these scissors, and you will never see them again. Caution, it will take effect on everyone in the picture except yourself.
Whoa.
What? That'd be weird.
Yeah. I mean, I honestly have a hard time picking, like...
Oh. This is, like, something from Yu Yu Hakusho, which is what the creator... of this show did before this show.
Mm-hmm.
The fledgling athlete, warm this magic egg in your hands for 3 hours a day. For 1 to 10 years, you will become a top athlete when it hatches. The stronger your desire during incubation, the sooner it will hatch.
Huh. I remember that one. They showed that one in the show.
Oh, okay.
I remember us talking about that one.
Yeah.
Fairy King's advice. The Fairy King offers you gentle, apt advice on what you lack or what you should fix. The annoying thing is he appears when he wants to.
And there's a bunch of fledgling ones. There's artist, politician, musician, pilot, novelist, gambler.
Yeah. Oh, so you can choose what kind of fledgling thing you want to be really good at. That's kind of cool. I like that. I don't know. As far as what Gon's goal was, his process that he did, I think, was great. Although, ultimately, out of all three things, I feel like they're worthless, except for finding Jean. That's it. You know? I don't know if the necklace will come in handy at all. Maybe, maybe not. I don't think the marble's gonna come in handy at all.
I mean, it's one of a kind, so you could sell it for a lot of money, but she already has a billion Jenny.
You say that, but you need to find someone who wants to buy that stone. You know?
To the zip pile.
I might pick this one. Night shift dwarves. They can do any work for you, and they will work as long as you're asleep. They cannot do anything beyond your abilities. You have seven dwarves, is what it says.
So while you sleep,
they do shit. I don't know why
that's
it's
awesome.
So funny to me.
Man, that would make it so hard, though. Because now I got to choose, like, when should I sleep versus, like, oh, shit, man. I really got to mow my grass. Better go take a nap. You know?
Just have them do it at night.
The alarm goes off.
Yeah, but then what if I can't sleep because they're mowing the damn grass?
Just have them use scissors. They do it tirelessly.
Gosh, God, that's terrible. There's another cutting with a ruler, making sure it's all 2 inches tall.
Well, they can cutting the scythe.
Yeah,
maybe.
Dude, this
that,
one
you can't get
cool.
it that low though. Scythe though, you're not getting that. You're not getting down to here.
You,
you know?
Can get
yeah.
really
you
low.
Get pretty
with
low.
Scythe. You can. You can. Shave dirt with a scythe.
I just appreciate like how creative all of these are, and like they put a lot of thought into cards that literally I don't think it's ever showed up. They made a whole system. It's like Tolkien creating a whole folklore so
yeah.
for his languages to make sense, you know? But university survey. Write various questions pertaining to yourself and give it to someone, and he will answer all questions honestly. Reusable.
Hmm.
Huh.
I wonder if they ever considered like making an MMO out of Greed Island.
What if they don't want to answer the questions? Do they have to?
They have to answer them honestly as long as
no, hang on. They have to answer them honestly, but do they have to answer them? You know what I mean? Like if I say Calvin, here, answer these 100 questions, and he's like, no. But if he did answer them, he has to answer them honestly. I wonder if there's like a
does it
you
say
know, like a catch 22 in there.
Does it say they have to answer them honestly? Then I like if it says they have to answer them honestly, then I would say
it says honestly, yeah.
They do have to answer them, and it is also their honest answer.
Revenge shop. Report your grudges to the manager, and he will retaliate for you in proportion to your grievance.
That one's pretty good.
Nice. Like any manager or what?
Retaliation.
Nice. This one is Club You Rule. Everyone in the club will do your bidding while you are there. However, 1 hour in the club equals a day outside.
Oh,
what?
Shit.
We could go on. There's literally hundreds of these, and props for just like.
Everybody clap your hands!
You know?
So great
I
for
can't pick which one I would go for. I don't know. The scales might be cool.
Is it 1 hour in the club and a day outside for everybody?
I don't know.
Or just you?
Probably just you.
It might just be
I
you.
Think people, those people exist in the club are only in the club.
Could you imagine, like, being a DJ, and, like,
yeah.
you go into a club, and, like, you're the DJ, and everyone's doing everything, and they're having a good time and stuff, but you're wasting a day of your life, every hour you're in there, but everyone loves it, and then you leave, and it's been 3 days later, because you were there for 3 hours? I don't know.
That's why you do short gigs.
Yeah.
Yes.
You get paid lots of money for a 10-minute.
One day.
Well, I really loved the arc. I assume that we're going on to a new one next time. So.
Well, being out of Greed Island, yeah.
We got these shirts out just in time.
I don't know what to expect.
Yeah. We did. Yes, we did. Oh,
next time.
See this again.
New arc.
I hope I see this again, Eric. Over at flyingwave.net/store or shop or either.
Just go buy on net, click the store button.
Okay. Yeah.
Or you know what, better yet, just go down to the description, click the link there, it takes you right to it.
My guy's missing.
That?
Where's he at?
He'll be back sometime.
Yeah.
He'll have his doctorate.